Hi there, welcome to another Friday Findings video. Today I'm going to tell you about yet another tool that I use a lot in my jewelry making and a lot more than you might suspect. And it's this little brass caliper. And it's used for, well, like calipers are, for measuring things, especially things in small increments. You can find one of these at most of your jewelry and crafting stores in the jewelry making aisle. And it's just a sliding caliper, and it's great and very useful for measuring your jewelry making products, such as beads. You just slide a bead in between the jaws, and then you can see your dimension. Now, an important thing to note when using these is that your measurement is from this line, this scribed line right here, not from the edge of the caliper. So this bead, as you can see, is about 8 millimeters. Or if you look up here, it's in inches, it's about 5/16 of an inch. Not measured from over here, but from the scribed in line on the caliper. When you measure beads, usually you measure them from hole to hole. It's like a round bead. This is an 8 millimeter bead because it's round and that's its one dimension. Or you might have a big ceramic bead like this one, and it's 30 millimeters. And often they'll have two measurements because it's rectangular in shape. So it's 30 by 22. Usually the dimension that's given first is the one that's from hole to hole. One thing I strongly recommend, especially if you're in the US and you're just getting into jewelry making, is that you acquaint yourself with millimeters. It's a lot easier than dealing in fractions of an inch, and most of your beads come with that dimension given. And your wire and most of these smaller components are just, you'll just be so much happier dealing in millimeters and centimeters than in fractions of an inch. Beads aren't the only thing you can measure. You can also measure wire. Like, here's some wire that my husband got for me out of some electronics, and he told me what size it was, but let's say I didn't know. I can use my calipers to measure it. And if you take a look, let me zoom in for you. You can see that it falls somewhere between 1 and 2 millimeters. But the cool thing is that you can actually measure up to tenths of a millimeter with these calipers. If you see these 10 little marks here after our first indicator mark, all you need to do is find the two marks on the top and bottom that line up with each other. So in this case, I would say it's the 6. So we would say this is 1.6 millimeters. And when you're measuring something, and especially when you want to get these fine measurements, make sure you leave the item that you want to measure in between the jaws. That will help you get more accurate. So we know that this is 1.6 millimeters, and that you can find a chart like this one that shows me, oh yes, 1.63 millimeters, so this wire is 14 gauge. Other things that you can measure are your tools. Like, I have this set of bail making pliers, and I keep forgetting how big each of these jaws is. So with my calipers, I can remember that one's 5, that one's 7, that one's 10. And with your round nose pliers, something I'm often mentioning in the videos is to use a Sharpie to mark your round nose pliers where you want to make your loops consistent. So if I set this at 2 millimeters and I want consistent 2 millimeter loops, I can put this on here and then use my Sharpie to make a mark, which I already have one on here, it's faded a little, and then I'll have consistent loops. So this is a great little tool, and once you get one, you'll find lots more uses for it. If you like this video, please be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you'll see more like it. Also up on the screen are a couple of jewelry making videos you just might enjoy. Thanks for watching. Happy creating. Bye-bye.